Welcome friends, today's topic is energy conservation and its importance. First refer the figure. The figure is the graph between billion tons of coal equivalent, which is coal reserves, to time. Okay, during the 1500 years before, we have to start the usage of coal or fossil fuels. Then the coal usage and fossil fuel usage is continuously increasing and it reaches the maximum at 2000. Okay, then afterwards, in certain years, for example 2030 or 2050, the coal usage is continuously abruptly decrease because of the coal reserves or the fossil reserves are continuously depleting. Okay, when we reach the 2500, we have nil resource of coal or fossil fuels. Okay, so we conserve the energy, then only we have increased the years for coal usage. Okay, then coal and other fossil fuels have taken hundreds of million of years to form, are likely to deplete soon. In the last 200 years, we have consumed 60% of all resources. For sustainable development, we need to adopt energy efficiency measures. Okay, today 80% of India's primary energy comes from non-renewable and fossil fuel or fossil sources. For example, coal, oil, crude oil, these are the examples. These reserves are continuously depleting with increasing consumption and will not exist for future generations. Then what is energy conservation? Energy conservation and energy efficient are separate but related concepts. Energy conservation is achieved when growth of energy consumption is reduced in physical terms. Okay, energy conservation can therefore it is the result of several processes or developments such as productivity increase or technological progress. On the other hand, if energy efficiency is achieved when energy intensity in a specific product, process or area of production or consumption is reduced without affecting output. Consumption or comfort levels. Okay. Promotion of energy efficiency will contribute to energy conservation and is therefore an integral part of energy conservation promotional policies. Then energy efficiency is often viewed as a resource option like coal, oil or natural gas. It provides additional economic values by providing the resource base and reducing pollution. For example, replacing incandescent lamp with the LED mean will require 1/8 of the energy to light a room. Pollution levels also reduced by same amount. This is the best example for energy efficiency. Then nature sets some basic limits on how efficiently energy can be used, but in most cases our products and manufacturing processes are still a long way from operating at this theoretical limit. Very simply, energy efficiency means using less energy to perform the same function. Although energy efficiency has been practiced ever since the first oil crisis in 1973, it has today assumed even more importance because of being the most cost-effective and reliable means of mitigating the global climate change. Recognition of that potential has led to high expectation for the reduction of future CO2 emissions through more energy efficiency improvement than that they achieved in the past. The industrial sector accounts for about 41% of global primary energy demand and approximately the same share of CO2 emissions. Here I presented some benefits of energy efficiency. In industrial sector, we have reduced energy bills, increased competitiveness, increased productivity, improved quality and increased profit. In nationwide, because reduced energy imports, avoid cost can be used for poverty reduction, conservation of limits resources, improved energy security. In global, reduce CO2 emission and maintain a sustainable environment. Okay. Then, energy strategy for the future. Okay, energy strategy means energy plan. How we utilize the energy in future for increasing the span length of the energy depletion time. Okay, the first strategy, immediate term strategy is, the strategies are rationalizing this tariff structure of various energy products, optimum utilization of existing assets, efficiency in production systems, and reduction in distribution losses, including those in traditional energy sources. Then promoting R&D, R&D means research and development, transfer and use of technologies and practices for environmentally sound energy systems, that is energy efficient drives, okay, including new and renewable energy sources. These are the immediate term strategies. Then medium term strategies, demand management through greater conservation of energy, optimum fuel mix, structural changes in economy, and appropriate model mix in the transport sector, that is greater dependence on rail than our road for the movement of goods and passengers, and a shift away from private modes to public modes for passenger transports, changes in design of different products to reduce the material intensity of those products, recycling, etc. Okay, then there is need to shift to less energy intensive mode of transport. This would include measures to improve the transport infrastructure, for example road, better design of vehicles, use of compressed natural gas and synthetic fuel, etc. Similarly, better urban planning would also reduce the demand for energy use in the transport sector. There is need to move away from non-renewable to renewable energy resources, for example solar, wind, biomass, etc. These are the medium term strategies. Then the long term strategies. First one is efficient generation of energy resources. That means efficient production of coal, oil and natural gas, and reduction of natural gas flaring. Then second, improving energy infrastructures, which means building new refineries. Second, creation of urban gas transmission and distribution network, and maximizing efficiency of rail transport of coal production. Then final, building new coal and coal-fired power stations. Then third parameter is enhancing energy efficiency, which means improving energy efficiency in accordance with the national socio-economic and environmental priorities, promoting of energy efficiency and emission standards, labeling programs for products and adoption of energy efficient technologies in large industries, for example 3-star, 2-star, 4-star, these are the things. Okay, then deregulation and privatization of energy sectors. This is a discussable one, but I tell. First one is reducing cross subsidies on oil products and electricity tariffs. Decontrolling coal prices and making natural gas prices competitive. And privatization of oil, coal and power sectors for improved efficiency. Okay, the point is I am not accept, but in text they are giving privatization of coal and oil and power sectors for improved efficiency. Okay, then the last point is investment legislation to attract foreign investments. Streamlining approval process for attracting private sectors, participation in power generation, transmission and distribution. Okay, these are the energy strategies for the future to consume less energy and increase the span length of energy consumption or energy depleting time. Okay, thank you.